one in five people will experience a significant behavioral disorder in their lifetime. One in five. And this is the point I want to make more than anything else. You know, there's much to our bodies, right? There are several organs in our body. There happens to be one kind of minor organ called the brain that we don't spend much time with. In many ways, it's almost like we have disembodied the brain from the rest of the body. And what I mean by that is, if think about it, when you go to your doctor for your annual physical exam, how many of you have had that doctor ask you, how are you emotional? How's your brain doing? Hands up?
No.
Nobody. Nobody. The brain and our emotional well-being is something we rarely, rarely ever talk about. What in the world makes us think, because this is an organ just like our heart or liver or lungs or any of those things, what makes us think that something is not going to go wrong at some point in time with that organ, just like it would potentially with any other? You know, when somebody is ill, and let's say they have a significant heart condition, as we refer to them, we would talk about, boy, something's wrong with your heart. Something's wrong with your cardiac system. But too often, if somebody has the courage to say, boy, I'm just feeling kind of depressed, feeling this, feeling that, emotionally, how does that come off? There's something wrong with you. Not your heart, not your body. There's something wrong with you. And that tends to be historically how mental health, emotional well-being is thought about. It's kind of like you're on your own with that. Sorry about it. You're on your own. We don't deal with that. This all adds to the silence, secretiveness, and all the other things that we think come into what we call stigma around mental health issues. It keeps people from talking about it. It keeps people from seeking help often, too often. And it is an organ in the body just like any other organ.